Hi everybody, it's Friday. I am gonna work out in a few. I decided to make the video now because it's getting kind of late. And I'm still on the fence about whether I should get drunk or not. So, it's been a very hard week for me. Where I last left you was a double vlog for Christmas. I guess it was my present to you. It was a shitty Christmas indeed. It was not even close to a Charlie Brown Christmas, let me tell you. My husband decided to be cute and fight with me and ruin my mood after I came home from visiting my friend. He gave me a lot of grief for it. So, yeah. There was a few battle wounds, as you can see. And the worst of it is on my legs, though. Oh, God. I have to wear a dress and... I guess I gotta put concealer on my legs or some shit. So yeah, he got a little cute on Christmas and gave me a couple gifts of his own. So what can you do, right? Except laugh at yourself and laugh at your situation. So I've just been really just keeping to myself. I haven't really been talking to anybody much. My friend got out of the hospital this week, and I'm glad she's home. She is doing good so far. It's been like 11 or 12 days or something that she has been binge and purge free, and she's actually eating now. Not a lot, but you know, eating. She's found safe foods, which is important. And she's still maintaining at a low weight, which I don't understand, but okay, whatever. It's not my life, so I don't care. She's been asking me, what is my goal weight? I don't like when people ask me, what is my goal weight? That implies that I am I'm trying to reach a weight, and that's just impossible, because as we all know, those of us suffering with eating disorders, it doesn't matter what milestone we reach, it's never enough. I mean, you can save 5 pounds, and then... next thing you know, you're down 10. You know, you're never happy. There is no magic number that makes everything all better. You know, nothing makes everything all better. So, I don't know. Like I told her, I don't know. You know, I don't like people asking me their goal weight. Especially like people that weigh less than me. Maybe this is the cynic in me and the Ed part that's, you know, the really horrible part of me. I don't like people asking me my goal weight because when they weigh less than me, because it kind of makes me think that they are making sure like I'm in check, you know, like, okay, bitch, don't get skinnier than me now, you know. I don't know why, God forgive me for thinking these awful things, especially about people I care about, but that's just the reality of it. So, yeah, but anyways, so, yeah, she's out the hospital, it's fantastic. I gave my friend my resume, and I don't know, let's see what happens. Maybe she can get me a job, even if it's part-time, even if it's something, you know. I just need to pick up the pieces after this guy moves out. Income tax is right around the corner. I think January 15 is the official day everyone can start filing. I get half of whatever return he gets, and... with whatever money he has, he supposedly has to move out, so that's it. I got my confirmation letter. Let's see if I can find it here for you guys. I think it's this one. Is it? Yes. And it says that, you see, it says I gotta move, okay? So yeah, I am off to go. The next available apartment is for me, and so yeah, it's good news. Makes me happy, makes me warm inside. So yeah, I got invited to a New Year's party, and I don't promise people that I'm gonna go to these things, because whenever I'm invited to stuff, my husband finds a way to sabotage everything, and so he was right on schedule with the sabotage. He told me his car had car trouble, and he's been riding around in my car. And so today, the mechanic got a hold of him and was like, listen, your car has a problem. Yeah, we have to fix it, obviously, but you can't ride your car to and from work, and that's fine. You know, it's not going to break down. You're not going to be stranded anywhere. So he has no choice but to get in his fucking car and leave my car alone. So now I have a car to go to the New Year's party. I originally was not going to go. Well, I couldn't go. I mean, he was going to have my car because he works tomorrow. And it made me all sad and stuff. But now I can go. So today I went to the store and I got my daughter some shoes. And me too. For this dress that I have. It's really cold over here. Let me see now. It's 62? 68. 68 now. 68 does not feel like 68 to me. 68 feels like 40 to me. Because apparently when you have less body fat or something, you freeze a lot. So, yeah. This dress is, I don't know if you can even call it a dress. I mean, it's a piece of fabric, let's say. It ain't gonna cover much, but at least it'll cover my bits. So, if it's cold, I'm gonna be really cold. And I don't want to lug around like the big snowstorm jacket that I would normally pop out with. But I can't do that. And the shoes that I got are even, they're not gonna keep me warm. So, let's hope that hypothermia does not kick in. And I'm not a freaking popsicle at the party. So, yeah. what else can I tell you? I am 108 today, still. It's okay. I'm maintaining. Apparently, this is my maintaining weight. I've been maintaining this bullshit for a long time now. So, I don't know. You see, that's the thing about this weight. You can't have a goal weight, because there is no goal weight. Who says that I wake up tomorrow 2 pounds less, you know? I did not binge purge yesterday, or was it the day before? I think I went like 2 days without doing that, but then today I did that. Oh god, and what a mistake. My throat hurts really bad, and it hurts to swallow, and it's like really, like it hurts. Like I purged twice today. The first time, as if it was not enough pain, I decided to do it one more time just to fuck myself up really good, and now it hurts. So, I hope that it's just soreness, you know, that it's not anything major or serious, and so I am really crossing my fingers and hoping that I can give that shit a break, that way my body can heal, because I'm just, you know, always pushing it to the next stage. I am dehydrated so much. I am so thirsty. I've been drinking everything today that I could get my hands on. Everything. I'm just thirsty. Oh my god. And my knee hurts still. I've been thinking about getting a cane. It's gonna be a nice pimp cane, because I'm gonna put a leopard print on that shit. I'm not gonna have one of those gray canes to help me with walking, because it does help. My knee actually locks up on me, and it's really painful to walk. So, yeah, I'm gonna have to have a cane now. Speaking of canes, I went to the store, right, and then I had to go get my cat food. Because the furry assholes eat so much. And I bought, you know, because all the Christmas candy and stuff is on sale. So I decided to just get one candy cane. Originally I was not going to get nothing, but this, for some reason, this strange candy cane enticed me. Because I don't like candy canes because they're peppermint. But this one was not peppermint. This one was one of the rainbow stripy ones. So this rainbow striped candy cane said on the package, and I wish I didn't throw the package away, but whatever. Number one, it was enticing because it was only 60 calories. And number two, it was enticing to me because the thing said that it was a sour candy cane. And it had sour... No, it didn't even say sour powder. It just said it had powder inside of it. So I'm thinking like a pixie stick, you know? So here I am, because I can't wait to eat it. Because I haven't eaten all day. I've just been drinking. So I'm walking down the street with the candy cane, right? And I bite the thing, and at first, like, there's this sourness to it, and then it's just like that pure sugary, yucky candy cane sugar. So, the candy cane lied to me. Apparently what it was, maybe I read the packaging wrong, it was sour powder inside of the candy cane. But I had to, like, eat the candy cane, but I didn't want to eat the candy cane. I got pissed off after that. So basically what I did was chew and spit the candy cane. I just kind of bit it and sucked out the powder and spit the rest in the middle of the street, which was like so funny because I don't care like other people, you know. But once I get into like my neighborhood and there's people around that I know that's different. But like strangers, whatever, you can look at me. There's crazy people, all sorts of crazy people up and down my street. So I blend in pretty good. So here's this blonde bony lady walking down the street spitting out candy. I look like freaking my own Hansel and Gretel leaving a trail of freaking candy cane. And I managed to get all the powder, which is cool. I got to my neighborhood. That's how big the candy cane was. I mean, it was a bunch of blocks. So it was worse when I got to my neighborhood because all these men are outside. And I'm telling you, it's nothing but men where I live. And they all say hi to me. I don't know none of their goddamn names, but I could tell you who they are just by looking at them. So I'm walking down the street with the candy cane, and every time I would see someone, like I couldn't spit it out because I didn't want to chew and spit in front of these people because they're going to be like, yeah, we knew she was nuts. So I had to hold the stupid sugar crap in my mouth and then spit it out, and then here comes the next guy, and then I had to do it again, and then, you know, oh God, it was awful. So yeah, but that was, I think that's the last time I'm ever going to eat a candy cane. Ugh. So yeah, what else can we cover here? So I think that's it. I'm gonna go out after workout. It's getting pretty late. And let's see what happens tomorrow. I hope to hear from you guys. In the new year, there's a lot of bloggers that have gone missing. Which is just sad, you know, because you guys, like, I really took an interest in your lives and, you know, really cared about you. And there's a lot of you that are blogging less, including myself. So I think that's what happens when we either get a life or we get worse. So I don't have a life yet, so my excuse is that I'm getting worse. But anyways, talk to you guys again tomorrow. I'll try to blog. It may be a late drunken blog, but vlog, excuse me, but at least it's something, right? So good night, everybody.